now we'll have addressed by Sri Manohar Ashtavadhani. He's on structural maintenance and audit. So I'll be introducing him before he comes and speaks. So Sri Manohar Ashtavadhani is a structural consultant. He has more than 50 years of experience in this area. He completed his BE Civil in 1967 from Pune University. And he has served for 35 years in PWD, Government of Maharashtra, and retired from there as a superintendent engineer. Post-retirement, he has a personal consultancy service for the last 15 years, where consulting is done on structural design, structural audits, private and government buildings, including RCC, load-bearing structures, heritage type of buildings, and he's done about audit of 500 buildings in private and government repairs and rehabilitation. On a personal front, he's also been a technical expert for infrastructure with Quality Council of India. He's a technical advisor to banks for big infrastructure projects on roads, highway projects, and even the tunnel project on Jammu-Srinagar Highway. So it's my pleasure to introduce and welcome Sri Manohar Ashtavadhani. Please address. Thank you.
First, my presentation. Actually, I just want to brief the history of the structural audit. Actually, this structural audit has come up during for last 10 to 15 years. Earlier, there was no term of the well-known term of structural audit. But it is the history of the structural audit that the old city in Bombay, they were rental buildings. And the rent was very small. And the owner could not maintain those buildings. And there were a lot of incidents of collapses in that Kalba Devi, Bhendi Bazaar. I remember there were so many collapses between 65 to 67. Then there was nobody to take care of these buildings. So Bombay, Government of Maharashtra formed the Bombay Housing Repair and Reconstruction Board in about 1969. And after that, the repair of these buildings was taken up by the government itself. At that time, some societies were coming up in the north region with the corporate society. And these actually requirement came in 1990, after 1990, when this building started a deterioration in this building. It was, and some concrete building also collapsed in about 1995 or 2000. Then the BMC insisted for the structural audit and repairs as suggested by the structural engineer. That is history. Earlier though, there was no common term as a structural audit. Then in the government buildings also, there was no structural audit system. Nowadays it has started, but all these government, state government, central government buildings, there was no system of structural audit. But the officers, they used to inspect, there was a register in the government department to inspect the subordinate, means whatever the superior officers and subordinate, depending on the size of the building, every 6 months, and inspect and identify the defects and take up the repair. That was the system going on. But nowadays, last 10, 15 years, audit is compulsory nowadays. This is the history of the structural audit. The need of structural audit, why it has come up? Because of defects, distresses, and structural problem in the building becomes unsafe. Second point is, in case of dilapidated building, the MCGM issues notice under section 353B of MCGM Act. And they ask you to submit the report within 1 month. And whatever the defect, damages, and distresses pointed out but structurally, you have to repair within 6 months. And after completion, you have to take the stability certificate from the same structural engineer, and that structural stability certificate is supposed to be submitted to BMC. That is a requirement of the BMC as per this act. And if you delay that, then there will be a penalty of 25,000 rupees per year in your assessment. So that is actually as per the provision in the Act. Submission of structural audit report is performed on B. Actually, what has happened in earlier days, means about 3-4 years back, every structural engineer used to submit the structural audit report in his own format. So there were a lot of information, say big booklets they used to prepare. So BMC officers, it was very difficult to scrutinize those. Okay, what is the requirement, what is the condition, and what is required, whether it is safe or not, that they were not understanding to and how to file that report. That was a problem. So they have actually came out with some format B, And that is a lot of questionnaires are given, and you have to classify the building. My structural engineer has to classify the building in category. So those categories are C1, C2A, 2B, and C3. These I will explain you. This is like actually this performer B was introduced by the BMC. Repair, recondition of the C1 category, redevelopment. A most dangerous building is identified as a C1 category. So that is unsafe for the stay, and you have to vacate it immediately. So that redevelopment has to be taken up. It is a requirement of the Bombay region. This damages to the structure and structural audit is actually the requirement in the Bombay and coastal region in the saline atmosphere, heavy rainfall area. But you will not find these damages in the Pune or Delhi or Nagpur in the dry area. The durability and the life of the building is more. Damages are less. So there is no, so far, the requirement of structural audit. So this is in Bombay and this Thane and this surrounding because of damages. It is a license, and this MCGMA has made it mandatory after 30 years and after every 5 years. It is by the licensed structural engineer with the BMC. The type of IV, just I wanted to brief you what are the damages and what is the rectification. Before that, it is necessary to introduce the type of the structures. There are two types of structures. One is the load-bearing structure. It is life is 100 years. Load-bearing structures, there are wooden timber framework and column beams, they are wooden, and stone masonry or brick masonry, which is carrying the load. So these structures are long-lasting. In Bombay city, all these heritage buildings are load-bearing. There is a use of wood is more, stone is more, and so life is prolonged. And generally, it is more than 100 years. In RCC frame structure, the use of cement and steel is there. So it gets corroded. So this life, because of this climatic condition of Bombay, there is a cracks in the columns, beams, slab, and so this get deteriorated. So this is arson. The life of the building in normal climate is considered as 80 years, but in a severe condition like Bombay, it is about 50 to 60 years. Seven. Scope of structural audit and purpose. So what is the purpose of the structural audit? The inspection of the existing condition of building, then assess the existing strength of the building components and load carrying capacity. After 30 years, 40 years, or what is this, all these structural members, this RCC member, column, beam, slab, foundation are the backbones of the building. So get that, these are damaged because of climatic condition. And hence this, you have to assess the capacity and load carrying potential. So that is a part of structural audit. Recommend the remedial measures for safety of occupants and extending life of the building. So for that, structural engineer has to suggest you with remedial measures, whether building is most dangerous to vacate it, or whether it is repaired, how it is to be repaired, how it is to be strengthened. So that is a part of structural audit. Then once you give the job to the structural engineer, how he assesses this term is what, in what stages he inspect your building and what, how is the methodology of structural audit that is given. The method first is a study of record architect drawing and structural drawing. So this is a mandatory that madam asked me the question, what are the document? So these documents, these record plans are very essential, because what is the foundation, whether it is a pipe foundation, is a rod foundation, it is a footing, and what is the steel content in each column, what is the content still in the slab beam, that also structure has to know. So these record drawings you have to collect from the, whenever you are taking the possession of the building, you have to collect these record drawings and keep on your record. There is one society who is a retired officers, IS officers of government of Maharashtra. I am auditing that building also, advising for the, but they have maintained the record so nicely. He has got all record drawings of RCC and structural, all structural drawings and architect drawings. So it is easier for the structural engineer to give the solutions for the repairs. Study of architecture features, specification, structural arrangement. In every building, what are the features he has to study? Because this, suppose there is a problem of leakage or something, but it is why it is cropping up. So what are the, whether the projection, chajjas, where it is, there is a lintel or it is a continuous beam. So what are the defects in that he has to assess from the specification and features of the building. So structural engineer has to study that architect features, specification, structural aspect. Detailed visual inspection of the visible component to note. Actually, whenever structural engineer goes in the building, so every flat has done a lot of interior. There is a false ceiling, which is done 10 years back. There is a cladding to the columns, which is done about 10, 15 years back. So we cannot assess the condition of the ceiling and also column or beam. That is most essential. Otherwise, you will not find any problem from outside, but there the column is deteriorated, it is dangerous to the building. So it is necessary for you to keep the all the hidden components open for inspection. And also it is a responsibility of the society to ask the members to open the false ceiling or cladding or something and get it part inspected. They are reluctant because there are damages and they again invest for the interior or something. So members are generally reluctant, but the society should insist for that. Then location, the structuring has to mark the location of damages, type of nature of distresses, the cracks, settlement, any part is hollow, the concrete or something, the spoiling of concrete. The spoiling of concrete in ceiling is most critical, because if there are cracks in the ceiling and in our structure, the slab has a very less cover, so there is a steel is very near to bottom of the concrete floor. So wherever there are cracks, many times there is spoiling or cracks or something, it falls down suddenly and if hits somebody's head or old person or children, is a very risky. There is news in the media, a slab has collapsed and there is a casualty. There is a slab never collapses, most of the cases, unless it is a very dangerous. But only the part of the portion, it falls from somebody's head, it is very dangerous. So whenever there are any cracks in the ceiling, immediately break it, keep it open, don't plaster or something. If it is delayed, okay, but at least first stage is to break that cracks and to keep the portion exposed. So that cracks in the ceiling are most dangerous. Location of leakages and seepages to be marked to get a big building should be watertight always. For the durability of the building, we take care of the leakages and seepages. So in during structural audit, we mark the leakages and seepage location. Documentation with the photography and making and marking on the plan. So whatever the damages are there, generally structural engineer marks on the plan and also take the photographs to give the solution. Summarize the nature and quantum of distress, leakages, and then study the causes of distress, seepage, and effect on structural stability. Offer, noting all these defects and damages, he summarized his report and gives you the solution with the root cause of the damages. Interaction with the occupants, maintenance staff, and to understand the problems and repair history. See, it is also necessary for the structural auditor to understand what is the history of the repair and something. Then suggest the remedial measures, economical, practical, and workable. The solution should be also economical, practical, and workable. Cooperation from the occupants needed to allow the inspection of hidden part behind false ceiling, wall cladding, furniture, etc. And then the structural audit report, actually BMC has prescribed that format nowadays. So we are putting all this information in the format. There are a lot of questionnaires are there. So generally whatever we are noting out is coming on the record in the format B. But the category of the building, the BMC is very keen to make this category of the building after 30 years. So those categories are dependent on the different damages and distress and the C1 category is to be evacuated, demolished immediately. So if we categorize in this, the BMC and send to BMC, the BMC immediately ask you to vacate the building. They themselves follow up this because there is their shoulder, responsibility is on their shoulder also. Then 2A, to be evacuated and partial demolition requiring major structural repairs. So this category, you have to take the permission from the repair for the repair of the building from the BMC. 2B, no eviction. Only structural repairs. In this case also, repair permission has to be required, to be taken. C3 category, no eviction needed, minor repairs only. All these tenantable repairs, what they define as a tenantable repairs comes under this category, that is plastering, then painting, waterproofing, and plumbing. For these, you need not take the permission from the BMC, you can do your own interest and durability and stability. So these in this category, structural engineer has to classify the building. And again, on this, whenever you submit this information to the BMC, there is a one page attached to the report, and there is a checklist from the concerned technical staff of BMC, that is an executive engineer or something. They come, he comes and verifies whether the structural engineer has given the realistic report or not, whatever the question that we give, this answer we give, and whatever the format we use, whether it's correctly filled or not. In that format, this format has attached, if the time permits I will show you, otherwise in the format all these information is there, and they are critically, they are asking us to whether there is any additional alteration in the building. So that we have to point out. If there is any additional alteration notice, the BMC will make you the notice. And also there is a one question, what is the cost of the repair? That is one question they are asking. And what is the cost of reconstruction? If it is a most uneconomical repair, so they, BMC will write or ask you to take up the redevelopment also. So the cost of the repair also we have to mention. In the road bearing structure, what are the damages generally? The settlement of foundation of wall of column and cracks to walls and arches. In the old building there are sometimes arches, so those are, if there are cracks, it is dangerous to the building. Decay of wooden members, then leakages from the mangrove tile roof, leakages from drainage pipes, and termite problem. In Bombay suburb, this city, a lot of buildings are on this load bearing, and this type of buildings are there. So these are the damages we generally noticed. In this suburb area, only the villas or something, bungalows are of this type. Otherwise, all are now, it is RCC building. Possible reasons for distresses and damages. Why this building get damages? This RCC building, age of the building. If the age is more, then a lot of damages are happen on this. Poor construction quality. Actually, earlier days, the quality, these contractors and these were not keen about the quality. So, and there were no proper supervision, and there was no control of BMC. So, earlier this structural design of the building is done and as per the guidelines in the Indian standard. So Indian standard also nowadays improved after the experience. Earlier there was concrete, the practice to provide the concrete means M50, measurement to be cement content, cement, sand and aggregate ratio 1:4. And normal cover work provision was. But after this 80, 90, lot of improvement in the design concept is also introduced. There is a seismic design. Earlier building, there was not earthquake resistance. But now BMC is taking the certificate from the structural engineer that building is designed for as an earthquake resistance. Then there is a, they are appointed, now given the licenses to the supervisors, and they are asking for giving the occupation certificate. They are insisting for the certificate from the supervisor that building has been supervised by the qualified and licensed supervisors. So there is a lot of improvement. Earlier that quality was not controlled by anybody, so a lot of buildings constructed, RCC building constructed between 60 to 80s, they are getting more and more deteriorated earlier. If one example I will give you, the Khana Creek Bridge, there the earlier old bridge has damages because there was this tensile wires, they get corroded. But after the, because this design of the bridges is done it by the, as per the guidelines in the Indian Road Congress codes. But after that, after the experience, the Indian standard, this Indian roads standard also improved their concept. So they have insisted nowadays there is no such problem. So like that only in the building also, after the damages and experience, Indian standard, BMC, they are insisting for the better quality and design for the durability. Not followed the severe earlier in the construction, this criteria of severe climatic condition, extra cover, minimum cement content was not followed. So that is why these buildings were getting damaged earlier. Corrosion of steel due to saline atmosphere, heavy rainfall, reduction in diameter of power, loss of strength and weak structure. Defective waterproofing, leakages problem, additional alterations in the building without consultation of structural engineer. In many buildings, there actually internal changes are done without consultation of the structural engineer. That is why the society should insist to submit the plan. If somebody wants to do any interior or some minor addition, they ask for the plan of interior and something, and then they, in consultation with the regular structure engineer of the society, they should get it approved and then allow for the additional alterations. And then the reason for that is also overloading, wrong location of tank, loft tank, storage, dumping material on the loft and terrace. Then concealed water supply pipes, difficult to repair, leakage problems in the joint and building gates deteriorated. Then concealed electrical conduit slabs, beams, weak leakage problem. Electrical conduits are also concealed. So there we are finding many problems because earlier they were of MS. So they are getting the rusted and so there is some cracks in the ceiling because of that. Water supply drainage pipes are leaking. Poor quality of external plaster. Normally the plaster, specification of plaster is a two coat waterproofing plaster. One coat is waterproofing compound has to be, and second coat is the layer is programmed with now it is layer and waterproofing paint. So earlier those days only single coat plaster used to do and these are giving the problem. But now in the repair process, all societies are carrying out the plaster in two coats. So these are giving the cracks and leakage problems to the walls. Terrace, stormwater drains, no proper slope, the blockage of holes, no tiles over the parapet top. These are giving the problem on the terrace flats. Water supply drainage pipes leaking, pipe rusted, joints defective, pipes directly on the terrace and no pedestal. Some of the people, the society, they have kept the pipes directly on the terrace from this end to that end. So it is blocking the flow of water. So it is where the stagnation of water on the terrace, it always starts leaking down. So that care has to be taken. Then termite problem, the no timely maintenance. After studying reasons, rectification can be proposed. For the structure engineer, he finds the root cause of these damages and he gives the solution. General remedial measures. So how do building repair? What are the general methods of the repairs? RCC building, propping, if there is any part is very dangerous, then first stage is to prop the building to avoid any collapse. So propping of dangerous portion urgently for safety. Then second part is arrest the leakage, seepage by replastering, redoing the waterproofing, coating, repair, replacement of pipes on U brackets. Earlier days the pipes were used to fix on the wall, but now they have provided good brackets in the market. So you can keep the distance between pipes and so the plaster will not get damaged. Remove trees on the building from the root. Root get damages to the plaster. Remove unwanted corroded component and elevation features. One of the society at Andheri, while I was doing the structural audit, I found there were 19 conical arches on the terrace at the 7th floor. So these arches were such a location that actually after the reconstruction, the buildings on opposite, that those were not visible from road level or something. Those can be visible from the about a 1 or 2 kilometers or something. But they were giving a lot of problem to the terrace flats because these locations were such and slope was such a very steep. So actually no labor could dare to go on top and do the coating or repair to the waterproofing. All water, they were became this, pardis, they became hollow. Water was going down in the terrace flats. So last 5-6 years they were facing a lot of problems, they repaired everything but they could not find a solution. I gave them suggestion that you remove these arches permanently. And the 19 arches, concrete arches were removed and now this last year they could not find any problem. So it has become the watertight. So sometimes these elevation features give the problem because of age and something. So that has to, and the cost of the repair also increases because of that. It is a burden to the society. So that such part should be removed from the elevation features and also from external or terrace floor. Proper plinth protection drainage around, no stagnation of water around the building because otherwise the foundation get damaged. So proper plinth protection and pavement should be around. Remove unwanted corroded components, elevation features that I just briefed you. Reduce the load on the building by a lightweight material. If there is what, suppose the parapet is there, damage to the heavy damage to the building, you replace the heavily loaded part and put the, to extend the life, you have to replace it with the lightweight material. Galiting of RCC member. Earlier days, actually repair work process was with the galiting. The RCC, when there is a damage to the RCC, the galiting used to do. But nowadays it is giving a lot of problems in the government colony. A lot of the galiting was done in about 1995 or something. So there was GI mesh or something provided, and it is totally, it is a layer and it is totally coming down and hitting the people staying in the room. So it is dangerous and also not given. So nowadays they good chemicals are in the market. So now is a polymer, mortar, micro concrete process and treatment is there. So this granitic process has not stopped after 19th. Fiber wrapping to the RCC members. There is a one process to tie the columns with a fiber wrapping and increase the strength of the column. So this is very costly procedure. Jacketing to the column by additional concrete and steel. So if there are cracks in the, normally in the steel portion, there are a lot of cracks because it is always exposed to the climate. So in that portion, all the four sides are open. So additional concrete layer with the foundation is provided. So that is a jacketing. So that is also a required methodology. But in the upper floor, it is very difficult because otherwise you have to provide the, you have to break the walls on all sides and it is a problem to the occupants. And features also get changed. Polymer or epoxy grouting to the columns and beams and slab. These chemicals are available in the market. Good companies are producing the chemicals. Repair to with the polymer mortar, micro concrete to the RC member, replace the damaged steel, apply rust remover, rust preventive chemicals. Structural steel supports to the dangerous part. If there is any part is dangerous, we can provide the structural steel supports. And this will give the safety to the occupants. Replastering the external plaster, waterproof the coating and paint. Externally, that plaster is damaged. You can provide the replaster and also provide the coating and waterproof paint. And load-bearing structures, the types. Replacement of damaged wooden members by steel section. A lot of heritage buildings in Bombay city are repaired with this method. So this suppose there we have to take the permission from the heritage committee for this repair methodology. And also old buildings like Kalwadevi, Bhendi Bazar, these are not heritage, but repairs are required. So in this case, this decayed members are replaced with the steel members. Repair to the roof for waterproofing. Has to be provided to the roof. Redoing external plaster, RCC bands and settlement cracks. If there walls are cracked, this is a methodology, it's a technical process. Anti-termite treatment, because of this termite, wooden members get damaged, so you have to take care of this termite problem. One of the building, wooden frame structure about 100 years old, that is a ready It has very nicely maintained. All the commercial offices are there. I just audited these two twice, and there is a lot of problem of termite, and also there is no fire safety. I just advise every time I am advising you expose all these wooden members joints, but a lot of falsifying, then cladding is there provided because all good offices are there inside. So every time whenever I go for, I find a very difficult to. Inspect. So we are advising in such case to open the hidden part. Other points for the quality and safety. Indication for warning and this building is dangerous. What the society should immediately take action. So indication is sag and cracks in the building. If there are cracks in the building, the walls or beams and the slabs, then it is dangerous. You have to take immediate action. Sloping cracks to the beams, walls, settlement of foundation if it is noticed. If there is any कुछ ऐसा बढ़ गया कुछ हो गया तो देन दे ऑट टू बी वेरी पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम इन द कॉलम्स एंड स्लैब्स आर डेंजरस फॉर सेफ्टी आई जस्ट ब्रीफ यू सीलिंग क्रैक्स आर वेरी डेंजरस इवन स्मॉल पीस हिट समबडी इज हेड इट इज इट कैन बी फेटल सो यू हैव टू बी मोस्ट पर्टिकुलर अबाउट द सीलिंग क्रैक्स मेनी इंसिडेंसेस आर हैपनिंग बॉम्बे बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सीलिंग क्रैक्स रेगुलर स्ट्रक्चर ऑडिट बाय द कंसल्टेंट देन क्वालिटी शैल बी मेंटेन्ड ड्यूरिंग रिपेयर repair works, you have to maintain the quality, you appoint the structure engineer for supervision. Construction of structural consultant for major problems. Then safety precautions during repair activity. Whenever this, they start the repair for the high-rise building or something, some safety precautions, netting and things you have to take, provide.
So a few questions which have come, let us address them. One is, what is the frequency of the structural audit? Do we be carried out. The frequencies, I think after 30 years, it is once in
first, a first, because of those years, awareness is there. So okay. First is 30 years, they give the notice. But after 5 years, it is advised.
It is once in 3 years. It is once in 3 years. Earlier it was once in 5 years, now they are changing to once in 3 years, okay. After 30 years.
Stability is every 5 years, audit is 3 years.
Okay. Audit has to be carried out once in 3 years.
But it is not to be submitted to BMC.
Yeah. Maybe in the and once in 5 years we have to give the stability report.
That is for BMC.
After 15 years, so every 5 years.
Yeah. Yeah. 15 years to 30 years, as per the bylaws of the Co-Operating Society, it has to be structural audit has to be carried out once in 5 years. And after 30 years, as per the BMC, 333B section, it is once in 3 years. And stability report has to be submitted once in 5 years. So this is a frequency. The second is about the TDR loading. Whatever has to be done for the regular structure, same thing has to be done for the TDR loading also. If the existing building is more than 30 years, that's the once in 3 years you have to carry out the audit and thereafter you have to submit it to the BMC. Within 6 months from the date of carrying out the structural audit, you have to carry out the repairing required and submit a compliance report within 6 months. And if you do not carry out the structural audit, what is the consequences? That's the next question. So the consequence is, BMC can they come to know that the structural audit which is required to be done and compliance which is required to be done not done, BMC can appoint their own structural auditor, they can carry out all the expenses will be loaded on the society, another 25,000 penalty can be levied. And to the extent, if the structural audit after giving a show cause notice and the compliance is not carried out, the water connection also can be disconnected. So therefore, there is a stringent actions taken by the municipal corporation. The next question which has come is, who is responsible to carry out the audit? The responsibility is cast on the owners. The structural owner. Who is the structural owner? Naturally, in the case of a cooperative society, management of a cooperative society is vested with the powers of the management of the structure. And therefore, it is the office bearers and the managing committee who is held responsible. As far as tenanted building is concerned, the landowner and jointly, of course, the tenants, if the landowner do not take care, then the tenants also will be held responsible. Correct? So, next is, is it mandatory to carry out the structural audit? Answer is yes, once in 3 years, as per section 353B of the MCGM Act. Now, there was a question related to garage. Now, that is related to personal question, we can address it later. But even if the garage is more than 30 years old, still the structural audit has to be carried out. If the society does not carry out, then it is up to you to carry out and submit the report and carry out the stability of the garage also. Next is, about the submitting the report, whom the report has to be submitted. Report has to be given to the MCGM by the managing committee and it needs to be discussed in the general board. A report also needs to be submitted to the members. Whatever remedial action has to be taken within 6 months, it has to be taken. Now, how about MADA? MADA building also, the MADA is the owner. Naturally, the MADA will take care of that and of course they are also responsible and therefore there is a repair board who carry out the structural audit and thereafter stress building they also carry out the repairs if required, otherwise they are advised for the redevelopment. C1 and C2A building, which of course it cannot be repaired, then it becomes difficult. C1 cannot be repaired and therefore we need to explore the possibility of redevelopment.